Hi, I'm Stephanie, and this is Catherine from B&W Tech. Thanks for joining us in our educational video series. Today we're going to be talking about handheld Raman spectroscopy. So Catherine, can you talk a little bit about the benefits of handheld Raman spectroscopy and some of the solutions that it's providing as well?
Sure, Stephanie. Raman spectroscopy is a form of molecular spectroscopy, and it gives us a fingerprint, a chemical fingerprint of samples that we measure. So we can use it to uniquely identify materials based on that signature. And in the handheld, what we do is we have libraries or methods that we've developed that we compare what we're measuring to, so we get that rapid response of a pass-fail or a match for an unknown sample. Okay. Raman's used quite a bit in many different areas, but with the handheld, it's designed for the pharmaceutical industry so that we can measure the incoming raw materials which are required in the industry to measure. Okay. We can use this small format instrument in the loading dock, in the receiving area, or the dispensary, you can use it in the laboratory, or wherever you need to take your measurements.
Okay. So I see a lot of accessories laid out here. So what are some of these accessories and why so many? So like the one that's on it right now.
Well, Raman is a non-destructive technique, and one of the advantages of it is that we can make measurements through transparent packaging.
Okay.
This point-and-shoot adapter, as we call it, allows us to make measurements directly by pointing and shooting at a sample.
Sure.
So take, for instance, this sample here, which is mannitol in a plastic bag.
Okay.
With the point and shoot adapter, we can press this up against the here, and in our identification mode, we can make a measurement to then see and verify the identity of this material. So coming through here, I choose the method of mannitol, and then I make my measurement where I'm now scanning the material,
mm-hmm.
and it's going to be compared with the method and verify that it is, that the spectrum matches what the method was based on.
Okay.
So we'll get a rapid pass-fail result. So it auto-integrates and determines what the optimal measurement time is to get a good signal, to get a good response.
Okay.
And then it will then make that comparison to what we've said it is,
mm-hmm.
and verify that and give us then a pass result.
Okay.
So here, that's what we see here. We see the pass result and that it's mannitol, and we even have the ability then to look at what we've measured versus what our method is. So you can see that it's very similar, and that, of course, is in accordance with the fact that we get a passing result here.
Okay.
So the point and shoot allows us to measure, say, for instance, in the plastic bag, and if you went out to a loading dock, you could go and measure through the packaging in a drum by this way, by pressing against that and through the plastic inner packaging in a drum. We can also measure, say, through a blister pack like this,
okay.
where we could, again, press up against it. And the focus is such that we're not getting the plastic measurement, but we're getting the sample that's behind that. And that's
okay.
what we're actually measuring.
So that seems pretty versatile. So for some of these other accessories like this one.
Well, that is a vial holder, as you see. And here we have an amber vial, which contains ethanol placed
okay.
here. We can then easily interchange between our adapters. So we can put this one in place, put the cover on it. We want to keep the stray light out,
okay.
the ambient light. And then we can do that same procedure where we then run this against the method, or if it's a complete unknown, use our investigation mode, it'll search all our libraries to see what it matches with.
Oh.
So this allows us then to measure using standard disposable laboratory glass vials. So
okay.
this is the amber one, and this is a clear one that we can use. And this is, we call it our liquid vial holder, but if you're taking samples and storing them in vials for your retained samples, you could use this for solids as well.
Okay. Now how about like this accessory? What is this one used for?
Well, that one, Stephanie, is our bottle adapter. So let me put that in place, and you can see that this has a shape to it like this, right?
Mm-hmm.
So if you pass me that bottle that we have over there, which happens to be glycerin in a plastic bottle,
okay.
here we can press this up against the bottle, and again we're measuring through the packaging, and now we'll go and measure this as an unknown in our investigation mode. So we can press the investigation mode, give it a sample name, and now it will scan the sample, search the libraries to see what it has a close match to, and gives us a match or a no match result.
Oh, okay.
So here it's scanning. Again, it's such that the focal point is beyond the plastic bottle,
mm-hmm.
so we're actually measuring the sample that's inside the bottle. We're getting quite a nice signal in a spectrum here as it's acquiring the library. It searched the library now, and we get the match result to glycerin, which is
what the sample is.
Okay, great. So how about some of these other accessories here, like this one?
Well, that one, Stephanie, is a tablet holder, right? So this is designed to give you a very good focus on the tablet, which we would place right here on the top. And like with the others, we want to keep out ambient light so we can close that top.
Yep.
So this one too, we could place in place and make the measurement. This is what we call our right angle adapter.
Mm-hmm.
And this allows us then to do hands-free testing.
Okay.
Right? So we could place this on the front of the unit and then put the unit down like it is now and make the measurement of a sample without having to hold the unit or the sample while we're making the measurement.
Okay.
Another very versatile one is this, our immersion probe. This is a 316 stainless steel immersion probe. And with the length of this, this enables you to measure things that might be in a larger container.
Okay.
So if you had those drums in the warehouse, for instance, and you wanted to measure not just at the surface through the packaging, but to go further into the drum, you could put this on and make that measurement through this.
Okay.
One of the great things about this as well is that we have these disposable covers for it. So you don't have to worry about contaminating samples by going and putting your probe in one sample than the next. What you can do is you can make your measurement with the cover in place. After you make the measurement, it's disposable. You remove it, throw it away, and get a clean cover for your next measurement.
Okay, very nice.
Okay, yeah.
Great. So once you take the spectrum and the information is here on the unit, what happens to it then? How is that usable?
On the unit itself, you have all your methods in your library stored, as well as your audit trail, your users, because you have different levels of users on this, as well as the results that you've just run.
Right.
But in order to get your results out and report them forward, you then synchronize with your PC-based software. It's a database software where you manage your data, and you can export the data into a LIMS-compatible format. So you could line it up with your other laboratory data into your LIMS system.
Okay.
Or indeed within the database, you generate reports, which would be PDF reports that you could then print and sign off on and have all your results, as well as your audit trails and management of your methods and libraries is done in your PC-based software.
Okay, great. Well, thank you so much for your time today, Catherine. I hope you found this as educational as I did. If you have any questions, feel free to visit bwtech.com, or if you'd like to speak with an application specialist, you can call the number on your screen below, and we'll see you next time. Thank you.